Noloco is one of those softwares that has been on my radar for quite a while, and time has finally come for us to do a video about it. This has come to me numerous times, many people reaching out, and when you start to see a pattern, you eventually have to give in. So here I am gonna be featuring Noloco, doing a walkthrough and giving you my first impressions of the software. To be fully transparent, I haven't really dove into the software at all yet, so this is gonna be pretty fresh. If that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and we make it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. And there are so many different no-code tools, new ones coming out all the time, and yet we start to see patterns emerging when people start asking for introductions and for insights about certain tools, and Noloco is one of those tools. So I'm very excited to be featuring our first video on this channel about Noloco. And as I mentioned in the intro, I have not even really looked at the inside of this software yet. This is gonna be brand new, completely raw. Now, before we get into it, I first want to invite you to join me for some training. Anything that you do in Nocode revolves around understanding automation. And I'm gonna teach you how to build the foundation you need for automation in Nocode with my free automation training. Go ahead and sign up for that at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. I'll include links wherever you found this video. In addition, if you want to follow along with me here on the video, I will include our link to Noloco so that you can show a little bit of love back to the channel and help keep the lights on. So without further ado, let's hop on into the software. This is where I am on the homepage of Noloco, and I first just want to start with a high-level overview of what the tool is. So this is going to allow us to build a custom app that our business needs in minutes. So you can see they're already calling out that their ideal customer is a business. So bear that in mind. We can start for free, as is true with so many of these no-code tools, but eventually we're probably going to upgrade if we want those ideal top-tier features. So let's go ahead and jump in and take a look at what this is. I'm not gonna watch the video, but we can see that it looks like we're building a portal here, a front end, and it looks like they're suggesting that the data here is getting brought in from Airtable, which of course we use a lot on this channel, and we're seeing that there are many different ways that we can visualize this information. So here's a chart, but we also have columns, cards, boards, timelines, Gantts, all the standard stuff that you might expect inside of Nocode. So what is Noloco? Well, at first glance, you might assume that it is a front-end solution, some place for you to build that front-end that you can deploy your application, storing your data somewhere else, as this homepage suggests, like in Airtable. But in my brief research around Noloco, I have come to learn that that's not exactly the case. In fact, it's a more powerful tool than just being a front end. So in order to demonstrate this, let's go ahead and flip on over into the pricing for Noloco. You can pull this up at noloco.io/pricing. Now we have the three different tiers, and as is typical for software, we can toggle between monthly or yearly billing depending on how we want to pay. Of course, we're going to receive a bit of a discount if we switch to yearly. But what are the different features that we're getting at the different tiers? So first up, we have the starter tier. We have 10 users, that is people who can access our application that we deploy. A user in Noloco is different from a builder. A builder is somebody who has access to the back end of our Noloco account, and they are able to actually build things inside of our applications. Users are people that we deploy the application to, and we give them permission to access the application. So this is a very unique thing about Noloco. They are actually charging inside of their pricing model based on the number of users that you need access to. So if you're sharing your application with 10 or fewer users, the starter package is a good fit for you. You also have rows of information, and you might first draw down to synced rows and wonder what the difference here is. I know that was true for me, so I had to reach out to Noloco to ask, what is a row? What is a synced row? A row is actually inside of Noloco, because not only are they allowing you to sync with information inside of third-party software like Airtable or Smart Suite, but Noloco also gives you the ability of storing information inside of Noloco. So you can actually use it as a backend as well as a front end. So if you don't want to build your data schema inside of a tool like Airtable, you don't have to. Instead, you can use Noloco's backend, and that is what they're meaning here by rows. So you get 5,000 rows of data on the starter plan and 2,500 synced rows, meaning that you can sync up with 2,500 rows of data in a third-party tool like Airtable or SmartSuite. Now, we also get workflow runs, and so Noloco also allows us to perform automations inside of Noloco. So I like to think of Nocode tools as really filling one of three buckets. The three buckets are where I need to store my information, how I move my information around, and then lastly, how do people access my information? Now, in the early days of Nocode, 5 years ago or even before then, usually a software tool would only focus on one of these three buckets. So we had Airtable that was only a database, or we had Zapier that only did automation, or we had Softr that only did the front end. But as we've watched this industry evolve over the years, we're starting to see software that fits multiple buckets. Case in point, Airtable now has interfaces, so they allow people to engage with that information in the interface, but they also have the back end, and they also have the middle component of automations. So you have all three of the buckets now, in a way, being met by Airtable. And by the same token, Noloco is doing something very similar. Because right here, even in their starter plan, you're getting access to all three tiers of the different components here. We have the ability to store information in Noloco because they have their own rows. We have the ability to run automations because of workflow runs. And then lastly, what Noloco was originally built for as a tool is that front end component. So in this way, we can now have this one tool that fits all three of the components that we require when we deploy any kind of no-code solution. This is pretty exciting because it's going to drive the costs of these tools down as we don't have to integrate with all of these different things. Now, of course, for many of us, we still want to build that integration. We still want to have our data in Airtable or SmartSuite. We still want to perform automations with Make or Zapier. And for that, we can still use Noloco on the front end. Now, in terms of the other pricing here, we have a pro model, which increases the number of users, increases the amount of data, both native and synced, also increases the amount of automation, and then lastly, gives you a lot more permission. So you get record level permission and field level. Now, at the business tier, the highest tier, we're seeing more of the same. So an increase in the number of users, yet again, an increase in the data, an increase in automations, and lastly, and perhaps most importantly, an increase in the number of people who can build stuff on your account. This is especially valuable for an agency like ours at Gap Consulting, where we have multiple people who are building inside of the account and deploying solutions for clients. So now that we have an understanding how Noloco prices, let's go ahead and jump into our first example. Again, this is my first ever attempt at Noloco, and I want to start by building a backend in Airtable. So I have users here, I have days, so I've put out a couple days, and I have tasks. So pretty simply, if I were to organize by my link here, you'll see that I have two tasks for each day. So I want to make sure that I'm tracking my workout and my walking on any given day. The idea here is that I want to deploy a simple app just to myself. I am the only user back here, after all, the only user in this table. And so I'm just deploying this app to myself, and I want to check off and see when am I doing these things. So let's create a checklist here to make sure that we can mark them off as they are actually completed. So this is my back end. Pretty simple, nothing complicated. Let's jump into Noloco and take a look. When I first log in, it says, "Welcome to your app dashboard. Let's build the first app." I will smash on build an app, and the very first thing it says is, where do you store that information? So I can import files to Noloco, as we already talked about. We can store data directly in the tool. But for me, I'm building an Airtable, so I'm gonna go ahead and sync up. So once I make that selection, it's gonna ask what I want to call my app, and it's pre-filled out with Gap Consulting right here, .noloco.co. So let's move on from here and say next. And it's going to put together my first application. It takes just a moment, but not too long at all. And here it says, now, do I have an Airtable account? So I'm going to have to sync it up with my Airtable. So I can go ahead and say yes. Let's connect with Airtable here. It's going to open in a new window. I can authorize this information. I'm going to add a base here, and I called this Noloco first glance, and here it is. I'll make the selection and grant access to that base. So now I've given Noloco permission to talk to the data that lives in my Airtable, and I can go ahead and select the base here right from the next selection, and then, of course, give a name to this source of data so that I know what it is and I can go back to it over and over again. Now, I haven't tested this myself, but I have it on good authority that I can actually sync up to multiple sources of data as I need to. So if I have information living in multiple databases, maybe even in multiple tools, I can go ahead and bring them in to my application. Now that I'm set up with that system, I can go ahead and move on to the next section here, and it is going to perform an analysis on the tables that I have inside of my Airtable account. That took just a moment. Now it has completed that, and it's importing the data from the tables that I built inside of Airtable, and it's just importing it over here so that I have access to that data and I can start building the front end. As a fourth step here, we see that it's using AI to customize the app. The Noloco assistant is designing a layout for my app based on the data that I have. I've got to see how this works, because if it saves me time in building my application, this is going to just blow me away. So here we are. It's done the four setup steps required, and we're moving into the actual building of the application. So after just a few load screens, here we are inside of our application that, thanks to the AI, is already built for us. Of course, we can customize this, make modifications as needed. But if you recall, back on our application on our back end, I had three different tables. I had users, and then days, and then the tasks that I was linking to those days. And here we see that I have those three components already established inside of my application in Noloco. So here it is, users, days, and tasks. And that data is being brought in. It's now been synced with Noloco, and I can start building as I need to. So down here on the bottom left, it's drawing my attention to say to access the builder menu, to click right here. The menu then provides us with the tools we need to modify the page. And so just like that, I've now clicked that. Our sidebar is now open, and I can start tweaking this application and deploy a front-end solution to my Airtable system. Now, maybe I should have addressed this at the beginning of the video, but you might now be asking yourself, why would I want to build some sort of application in another tool if my data lives in Airtable or Smart Suite or anywhere else? And the reason for that is it has to do with how we want to share access to our information. So with a tool like Noloco, we can build that third component of any no-code solution, and that is how we share access to the application that we build. And so with Noloco, we can then give our users the capability of logging into our application, seeing only what we want them to see, and being able to edit only what we want them to edit. Now, as I pointed out already, Noloco is more than just a front end, because we can also store data there and we can also build out workflows. So if you're interested in seeing more about Noloco on this channel, let me know in the comments below. And with your feedback, I will be putting out additional videos that show you how to take these extra steps, like automations, like deploying users to a solution, etc. I hope you got a ton of value out of this video and choose to give Noloco a try. Any questions that I did not get to, be sure to drop them below. And in the meantime, keep on building.